As I told you that this is going to be followed by a one-on-one interaction. It's now time for this session, and the topic of the session is going to be lips move, but we don't hear what they are saying. The need to listen to your users. And the session will be taken by Mr. Shankar Nath. He's the Senior VP Marketing Paytm. Shankar has more than 15 years of experience in the financial services space and consumer marketing in India. A graduate of St. Stephen's College and IIM Ahmedabad, he has served in organizations such as GSK Consumer Healthcare, City Financial, and Aviva Life Insurance. Prior to joining Paytm, he worked as a head of marketing and direct for ICICI Lombard General Insurance. So ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together and welcome Mr. Shankar Nath on stage. Good evening and a very warm welcome to you.
Thank you very much. Hi, good evening. I think this is the last session, so thankfully we'll get over with it very quickly. So in fact, yesterday Jyotsna and I were talking and we couldn't come up with a good title, so we just copied from a Pink Floyd number and tried to put it here. And basically, what I'll try and talk about for the next 10, 15 minutes is a little bit about what we are seeing overall within the Paytm context as well as in society in terms of some of the changes that are happening and how it's become very important to kind of notice, observe that trend, take some actions to kind of exploit that particular trend, because if you don't, one can become obsolete very, very quickly. And this is especially true on the mobile and on the technology front. And thus, what becomes very important is that one needs to listen and observe, both at a macro level and at a micro level. And I want to distinguish between these two with a couple of examples. On the macro front, today we see, and there are lots of industries where we are seeing this, that there's a lot of disruption which is happening. And over the last half an hour or so, Ajay, of course, talked about what's happening with Netflix, Uber, Ola, and the on-demand services, right? Primarily because everyone is moving towards that. But it has taken a lot of time for the incumbents, whoever is there, to kind of notice this trend and take action. And when you don't, you can easily become obsolete, because the paranoia which is there, which needs to be there for the incumbents, is perhaps missing. Now, just as an example today, Ajay was talking about appointment viewing on TV. It's gone, okay? But Group M maybe still talks about it, and a lot of us spend a lot of money on it. So which is fine. But, and so where do we get the, so what do we do? So essentially what we then need to do is try and see alternatives which exist. Like today as a marketer, if I still keep spending all my money on soaps, I'm not being able to reach that particular person. So what we have tried as a counter to that perhaps is take up sports in a very, very big way. And perhaps that is the only real-time content which people watch. And there's no, even if you want to watch on Hotstar, if you are present on the field, then you will still get the user. The user will still see you. So those trends you have to kind of notice and be, and take steps so that you know where the puck is moving and you don't kind of stagnate at one particular place. Now, that is at a macro level, because any stray bullet can come and hit any organization, and very soon, in about a year's time, you may become redundant. But at the micro level, what do we do? What do tech companies do to kind of observe what their users are saying? And I give you a very specific example which concerns Paytm. Today, we have about 12, 13 crore of people who have downloaded our app, okay? And about four to five crore people at least use it once a day. That's a significant number. But what we have realized is that there is an upper ceiling that we are going to reach very soon, because our app is primarily in English. Now, when we look at whatever is happening on social media, we have very active forums on, be it Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, whatever, right? And when we go through that, we see a lot of people who are using the app in English, right? But whatever they are writing in terms of whether they like the app or they faced a particular problem, everything is essentially in their mother tongue, but written in the English script. Now, if you as a marketer need to see that and clearly understand that if you don't go vernacular in India over the next 2 years, you will hit a ceiling. There's no way you can grow only with English beyond a particular point. Now, those trends are very obvious, right? At a societal level also, you will realize that because of data consumption, of democratization, so many people are now on the mobile and are consuming content. But that content is primarily being consumed in the vernacular language. So if you, as a marketer or as a product guy in a technical company, do not take enough steps to have vernacularization of your content or of the process, product flow, then you are in a little bit of a problem. The other thing which we are seeing today, and one of the reasons why perhaps we have been able to establish ourselves as a brand, and I go back 3 years back. So when we saw we are very active on Twitter, right? And then we saw a lot of people who used to say that all these brands run consumer promotions, right? All the big FMCG brands run consumer promotions where somebody is giving a bucket free, somebody is giving a bowl free. They're different, free items which are being kind of given, right? And we saw 3-4 consumers who said that, you know, whatever is being given to me is not important, it's not useful. Why can't I get something like a mobile recharge or like Paytm Cash? Now, that is just an isolated comment, which perhaps if you don't listen very carefully, you will ignore, or you may choose to not act upon it. But the moment we saw that, we kind of sensed that there is perhaps a little opportunity if we talk to a lot of brands and we say that whenever you are running consumer promotions, why don't you use Paytm or use us as the gratification tool? Because mobile recharge or Paytm Cash is almost a currency. It's relevant to 90% of your people. It's a digital gratification. So you will know who are the users who redeem that, and we will subsidize the cost of your promotion. The brand loved it, which is great, because their users, they would get far more data in terms of who would use it. And on top of that, the brand would also advertise it. It was great for us because it helped us acquire new users. It helped us be on television all the time. And we at least were able to make an inroad into the branding space, because at that time we didn't have too much money. The thing is that this particular approach would just not have been there for us if we were not listening to a few isolated consumers on the social media space. So there are lots of nuggets of wisdom, and I think we as marketers, or many of us, get so closely bogged down with the kind of work, with the kind of campaigns that we need to do, we tend to ignore or spend far less time with our customer service people than we should do. I mean, I know lots of organizations insist that every marketing person or all people in key departments at least spend 1 day in their customer service floor. Now, many of them do it as a tick mark. I don't know whether the intent is there always, but if you really want to listen, I think that's the best, because that's where you get raw data. You just get to know what is going on, and that's the moment of truth. You may have done a fantastic product, like what happens with us is we keep launching different use cases, right? And then there are people who are saying that because of this unnecessary step that you have put, I cannot complete my transaction. So we kind of monitor the user flow very, very closely and very, very consciously, right? And then we have realized that even one extra step that we may have in this transaction flow will essentially mean a 10% drop-off. Now, on a big base, that's a very, very big number in terms of absolute numbers. So we kind of really look at this particular user flow, which is coming because there are lots of consumers who keep writing back to us saying that I got stuck here, I got stuck here, I got stuck here. I need to remove all those barriers or obstacles, because it's at least still a year back, the data connectivity was not good, data was expensive. Now it's, of course, almost free. But on low-end handsets, most of us here would have an iPhone or very expensive Android phone. It doesn't matter to us. But when you are in a tier 3 town, on a 5,000 rupee phone, which is just somehow hooked on to the internet, if your app or the product which you're providing in terms of transactions is taking one extra step means 10% of your users are gone because of that additional step. So those things we need to kind of really listen in and observe. But at the same time, I think there's also a little word of caution that we need to have, which is that there is a lot of chatter on social media and a lot of chatter on the digital space. It's very easy for someone to get a bit too carried away with something which may not really be useful. But then we leave it to the marketer's judgment and maturity to kind of work on which are the three or four different things that he really needs to see, and then take concrete actions on the basis of that and ignore the rest. And that judgment, I think, comes with a little bit of experience, with a little more time that you may spend in that particular sector. Just to give another example of being able to listen in. So when we launch these products, right, there were instances where there would be a customer who would be saying that, you know, I do XYZ, but I need to pay an electricity bill of my state electricity board, but you are not providing that service. Now, it's almost on that basis you can quantify and say that amongst these 15 electricity boards that I need to go and tie up with, which is the first one that I go? So because that kind of quantitative feedback is almost coming in from customers who are writing into you. Or for that matter today, I mean, many people use Paytm to pay at shops and, you know, buy a packet of milk, buy whatever. I mean, we are trying our best to make people use that. It's habit. It's a bit of habit formation. It's a big change because everyone, about 95-97% of the transactions happen in cash in this country. So it's not easy. But what we have done with our users, we are essentially telling, we have run campaigns where we have told our users that if there is any particular outlet where you would like to pay with Paytm, but people are not, but it's not being accepted, why don't you inform us? Rather than this other push process where there's a big distribution force which goes out into the market and then tries and signs up everyone, that's very cumbersome. Instead of that, you know, here are these shops. Here, in the GK2 market, let's say there are 500 shops, out of which 20 customers are telling me that in these 10 shops, I am not being able to pay with your particular payment instrument. Now, that feedback coming in to us through social mode or through any digital mode is far more useful than an army of people trying to go and sign up all the other 500 shops, because I know that in those other 480 shops, maybe there is not enough demand in any case. So these kind of things, I think, are very important from a marketeer's perspective. And once we do all of this well, it can have significant inputs both into the distribution and into the product development and delivery. So that is one part. The other thing, I think, which is today become very, very important for all people in the marketing fraternity, is that earlier on when we started working, right, we would have one annual plan, we would have two or three campaigns in a year, and we'd be very happy with it. But today, the situation itself is so dynamic for us that the annual planning process is redundant. It's useless because there is a plan which happens almost once every month. There are different categories that you may be fighting in. There are different competitors that may be coming in. So if you really just focus only on a very, very rigid one-year marketing plan, then chances are that by the time you go to the market has moved on to come something completely different. So I think we as marketers also need to change our mindset a little bit. And I see a lot of people in this room who might have worked for 15 years, because 15 years is a long time. And I think the market has completely changed, but we still have a particular tendency to work in a pretty straight-jacketed manner and essentially do things the way we have always done before. And I think it's changed completely. It's a set of new tools which are there in the market. It's necessary for us to be far, far more agile and take decisions in an instant rather than, you know, relying on market research, which maybe takes 2 to 3 months for it to come on board. And by the time the results have come, the market has moved on to something else. So broadly, I mean, what essentially I'm trying to say here on the listening in front and the fact that there is the
the scope, the scale of change and the pace of change has become so much that if you don't listen to what the people are saying across all your distribution, across all your channels, then there is a very, very good chance that some stray bullet or some development in the industry will come and make you completely obsolete. And that's the paranoia that all marketers like us need to have to survive. Thank you.